Local breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
A former public works director says he's lost nearly a year of his life because he was wrongfully accused of a crime. Evening, I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. Last August, police charged Greg Fincher with kidnapping, but the solicitor's office has now dropped that charge. News 4's Parul Joshi is here now. And Parul, prosecutors were unable to meet with the alleged victim?
Yes, Carol, and that's why Fincher is no longer facing that charge. He told me today he went from a somebody to nobody in just a couple of hours, and that had a devastating impact on his life.
In America, with the exception of the city of Malden, you are innocent until proven guilty. I was never afforded that.
The former public works director for Malden doesn't mince words when it comes to expressing how he feels since he was arrested. Last August, police charged Greg Fincher with kidnapping.
I knew all along that I didn't do anything wrong.
Chelsea Fowler told authorities Fincher wouldn't let her leave the public works building and that Fincher offered her beer and solicited sex in exchange for a job. Fincher said that never happened.
She called me and said, I'm in Malden, can I come by? Can I pick the application up? And I said, yeah.
Fincher says Fowler left, and the next thing he knew, he was in handcuffs.
It's like a tornado. You know, one minute you've got everything just like it is now, and the next minute, you know, all the trees are blown down, and there's nothing there.
The solicitor's office dropped the charge because prosecutors say they were unable to meet with the alleged victim.
I think that it gives some validity to the fact that I didn't do anything wrong. I know what happened. The good Lord knows what happened. And he's on my side, so I'm good with that. You know, I can sleep at night. I can look at myself in the mirror, and I know what happened, and I know what didn't happen.
But what Fincher says did happen is the charge destroyed life as he knew it, and he thinks he'll never get it back.
Now, Fincher tells us he hopes to get a job soon. Carol?
Thank you, Parul. Remember our story yesterday featuring a Westminster mother who foiled a burglary of her daughter's home? Well, it turns out deputies arrested the wrong woman. Deputies charged April Lycia with burglary and grand larceny. Those charges are expected to be dropped after deputies realized there was a second woman with the same description. 22-year-old Brittany Ann Fulbright faces burglary and grand larceny charges. Stephen Allison faces the same charges. Deputies say they received a tip that the Chevy Blazer used in the robbery belonged to Allison, and it was reported stolen. Investigators found that Allison had a daughter fit the description of one of the robbery suspects. Deputies say the robbers were trying to steal a flat-screen TV, other household items, and a banjo.
Also in Greenville County, a 71-year-old man tonight stands accused of having sexual contact with a 6-year-old child. Authorities charged Lynn McNall with criminal sexual conduct with a minor under 11. Deputies tell us he inappropriately touched the child on several occasions. McNall also faces several counts of sexual exploitation of a minor. Investigators say child pornography was found on a flash drive in his home. We're told the crimes happened in Greenville County from 2011 until mid-July of this year. Now to Anderson, where a man accused of murder will stay in jail, at least for now. A judge denied bond this afternoon for Curtis Fowler. He is accused of shooting Brian Howard to death at a home on Martin Avenue last month. Officers tell us they found Howard shot in the head there. Police also tell us the two men were acquainted.
Remember this? The rains from earlier this month are long gone, but there are some lingering effects. This is Darwin Wright Park back on the 11th. The water has receded, but there's a lot of damage. We're told the city does not have enough people to clean it up, so the park is still closed. So, Lights of Hope is asking for volunteers. Cleanup will begin next Wednesday from 9 in the morning until noon. The record rainfall has also had a negative effect on farmers. The flooding of the French Broad River drowned many crops in western North Carolina, slashed fields, and boosted costs for farmers to spray more fungicides to hold off diseases. One farmer says he lost 300 acres of sweet corn. Another farmer says he lost 85 acres of crops. Landslides have also plagued our area. The city of Asheville tells us there were at least 20 there. Some of the heaviest damage were Skyview Place and Spooks Branch. The road will be closed in those areas. Repairs for Spooks Branch will hopefully wrap up by September 21st, and Skyview is expected to be done by October 21st. Meteorologist Chris Justice is in for John today. And Chris, is the heavy rainfall and flooding a thing of the past for now?
At least for now, Carol. We are still tracking some severe weather actually across the area. Most of us enjoying the lower humidity and the benefits that come from that with drier air and no thunderstorms. But yeah, you betcha, some severe weather going on up toward McDowell County. Now moving into Rutherford County, a lot of lightning associated with this one, as well as some torrential downpours. Let's put a track on it here. It'll be heading toward Rutherfordton right about now, Spindale at about 6:04, Danielstown at 6:16, and then Sandy Mush at about, say, 6:21. This system has hit a history of producing marble-sized hail, so folks, don't be on the roadways up that way. Also toward Rabun and Habersham counties of Georgia, right along Clarksville here, this is headed down toward the south and east as well. Also, you go up the mountain just a bit. Here in Transylvania County, this storm has been in the same area for about 2 hours now, heading down toward Pickens County. So travelers rest, seeing some light rain showers and another one developing on the outflow of this one here in northern Greenville County. So Taylor's heading on over toward Greer. You might see a heavy shower or thunderstorm here in the next little bit with some lightning. Also, we're tracking Tropical Storm Dorian. Here we go again. This one now winds up to 60 miles per hour. I'll show you the track on this and what we can expect for our forecast coming up in just a few minutes.
We'll see you then, Chris. Thank you for that. Well, the South Carolina Gamecocks are just weeks away now from kicking off the 2013 college football season. And tonight, we're still in the high talking season, of course. Sports Director Brad Fralick has been doing the listening in Columbia today, and he joins us now. Brad.
Steve Spurrier at his annual media golf tournament addressing the new targeting rules. Remember, one ACC official said Jadeveon Clowney's hit would have caused him an ejection this year. Now, the head of the SEC officials said that's a clean hit. Steve Spurrier said the only thing he worries about is the discretion between officials.
The only thing I don't like about a lot of rules is they're all judgment caused by the referee. The celebration penalty, was that one that deserved it or didn't deserve it? So it puts a lot of power in the hands of the referee. ACC ref said, oop, penalty, he's out of the game. SEC head guy said, good hit. So you got to ask them referees. Don't ask me how they're going to call it.
Over the last week, we have heard a few comments from Jadeveon Clowney about some opposing quarterbacks he faces. Here's Steve Spurrier's thoughts on Clowney talking, coming up a little later in sports. In Columbia, Brad Fralick, WYFF, News 4.
All right, Brad, thanks for that. And speaking of all that, we have something special planned for all of you football fans. WYFF 4 is giving you a chance to win tickets to the home openers of the Gamecocks and the Clemson Tigers. The Gamecocks will open the 2013 football season on Thursday, August 29th, hosting the North Carolina Tar Heels. The Tigers kick off the season Saturday, August 31st, hosting the Georgia Bulldogs, and we want to help you get there. Enter a chance to win the tickets. All you have to do is like the WYFF4 Facebook page and enter there to win. You do have to be 18 to enter, and the contest will end at noon on Thursday, August 22nd.